We sat down with Philippe Couillard earlier in the day at his downtown office. So let's start with this wildly inaccurate story, focusing on this mosque in NDG. You know, that inflamed sort of intolerance. Aside from the questionable reporting, you know, was there more at play there? How did you interpret how it played out?
You know, it shows how fragile this topic is in our society and other societies as well. I'm happy that TVA apologized finally for, because they realized the impact the report had, and I'm sure it made the community, the Muslim community, they're very feeling very unsafe. Mm-hmm. Hopefully this is behind us. But again, it's a reminder of how fragile this whole question is.
Yeah, and speaking of that, we are approaching the year anniversary of the mosque shooting in Quebec City. Yes. So it brings up the question, you know, a year later. Back then, we said never again. We said we'd rise above our cultural differences. Have things changed in Quebec?
You know, societies, unfortunately, modern societies are more and more polarized, and often polarized on identity. Not only on identity, or socioeconomically polarized, geographically polarized between large cities and rural areas, but also polarized and fractured on the identity theme. And again, it's not only Quebec. You see this in many, many industrial societies now.
Mm-hmm. But heading into the new year, what is the responsibility of politicians?
State principles.
To sort of counter that.
Always state principles. Swimming against the tide. You must do this many, many, many times. Mm-hmm. But the only way to do it is to have principles and to voice your principles. Unfortunately, you know, politicians tend to exploit these events sometimes in a very negative way. And again, not only in Quebec.
Mm-hmm. Well, speaking of that, I mean, one could argue that Bill 62 fed off that intolerance.
Well, you know, it's hard for me to understand why people are surprised. This is what we said we would do since 2013. We were, even when we fought the PQ's charter, we said, no, this is not what we need to do. The only thing we need to do is to legislate on neutrality of the state, managing demands for accommodation, and the question of facial uncovering or covering.
It's the most sensitive issue as well. So there'll be no backing off Bill 62 in 2018?
No. Like in the rest of the things we said we would do, we are doing exactly what we said we would do. Mm-hmm. And to people who tell us that we should go first, what we said needed to be done, and that's it. If you need, Monsieur Legault, to say to people you need to go further, well, tell them why. Tell them how you would do it. As for us, we've fulfilled our commitment. We've done what we said we would do. And then we move for more practical daily life issues for Quebecers.
Mm-hmm. And it would absolutely be cynical for that to be political maneuvering. What was political maneuvering for sure was the PQ introducing the Bonjour High motion.
What a story.
And we've asked this before, but I'll ask again. Why give into that? Why?
You know what? This is interesting in many ways. First, the first layer of this, it shows how linguistic tensions are never far from the surface in Quebec. You know, it doesn't need a lot to be raised again. Mm-hmm. Second thing, obviously, we felt that we are completely neutralized the PQ's motion, which initially called the word high irritating, which was horrible to say, which basically we removed. There is no coercion. There's nothing in the motion that prevents people from saying anything, essentially, if you look at it for what it is. Mm-hmm. But then we underestimated the impact it would have on our English-speaking fellow Quebecers, and this I recognized right away. This is why I did a very rare thing, never been done before. I raised it in the Assembly, answering in English to a question asked in French, which no Quebec Premier has done before me. Mm-hmm. And I did it on purpose to send a message to all first-class Quebecers. Now, beneath this, I think there's a need also for more empathy in the way we deal with each other. On our part, certainly, we underestimated the impact it would have on English-speaking Quebecers. Mm-hmm. On the other part, though, you know, we are a small minority in North America. We always try to keep the society as it is and keep its French face and sounds alive, particularly in a large city like Montreal. It's not an easy thing to do in North America today in 2017. So there's always, among French-speaking Quebecers, and I know that English-speaking Quebecers recognize this, a sense of being worried about the future of French in Quebec. Even if it appears to be doing fine, which it is according to numbers, you know, we are a small group under lots of pressure. There will always be significant pressure on the French-speaking people in North America, but we would try to keep it balanced and try to keep it coherent with our principles.
We all understand the interplay, and the motivations might have been noble, but what people saw was this linguistic bickering, perhaps, between the Liberals and the PQ. So is it any wonder that people might be searching for a third option?
Well, you know, this is why,
like the CAQ.
If you look carefully at the debate, we actually spent the debate defending the rights of English-speaking Quebecers to have their language heard in the public space. Now, coming back to the CAQ, I'd ask my fellow Quebecers, what do they have to offer you? Of course, separation probably will not be the main issue in the next election, but do they always say, only say sometimes good things about Canada? No. You never hear this from them. Do they have positions on poverty, on housing? Do they have positions on the labor shortage that we're facing now all across Quebec? No, they only use trigger-happy questions when they can use polls or front lines to make people more aggressive, feel more unsafe in mm-hmm. today's society. So my only question is, what do they have to offer you? And nothing. Quebecers and English-speaking Quebecers, because we know that the community as ours cares about poverty. For example, I will just table a very ambitious plan. We set up the Secretariat as we said we would, and it's going to be practically useful in publishing a plan of action, for example, increasing the opportunities to learn French for English-speaking Quebecers, and employment-related issues, which is a big concern, particularly among young English-speaking Quebecers that would like to stay in Quebec but want to see more job opportunities offered to them. So these are practical daily life issues that will be that we are addressing, mm-hmm. and we are the only ones to address those issues.
Inquiry into systemic racism yeah. was supposed to take place. Massive opposition. You backed off. It became a discussion about jobs and immigrants. But doesn't that conversation need to take place in a formalized way?
In any society, it should happen. But we must be careful that it happens in a positive way. What we did is David Hurtel, our colleague now at Immigration, represents a riding view which is extremely diverse, probably the most diverse, one of the most diverse ridings in Montreal. And he went around asking new Quebecers, what is your main concern? Is it racism, discrimination? What is your main concern every day in your life? Always the same answer, jobs, 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 access to jobs. Once we get access to good quality jobs, the rest of things we'll still have to deal with, but at least we'll feel safe and we'll feel like full-fledged citizens in Quebec, to which we chose to come and we want to be and we want to stay. So that's why we put the focus on jobs. It makes immigration a much more positive subject of discussion too. When I go to my region, when we also have labor shortage, I tell people, look, if this company must close its door or move away because of labor shortage issue, everybody's going to lose their jobs. Not only immigrants, but also Quebecers de souche, so-called, quote-unquote. Everybody is affected by this phenomenon. So we need workers. And the good thing is that employers say in the region, give us workers. I want workers from any continent, any color. I don't care. I want workers. I want to keep my company active.
You're the premier. Yeah. It's the end of 2017. Heading into an election year, give you the final word. What do you want Quebecers to retain about the Liberal Party heading into 2018?
First, we did exactly what we said we would do. We have a very good record, one of the best records in recent years, I would submit. But I'm not going to run only on our record. I'm going to run on a new plan for Quebec, centered, as usual, on economy and public finances, but also on quality of life issues, work-life balance, mobility, education-related issue, healthcare-related issue, natural caregivers, these type of things that are very practical, day-to-day issues for Quebecers, for which you need to have the means of your ambitions. Hence the need to keep the economy thriving and the public finances well managed. That's the message.
Well, happy holidays.
Happy New Year to everyone.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.